friends from high school married their high school boyfriends, moved into houses in the same zip codes where their parents live, but I could never follow. No,
so it's midday, well, just gone 12:05 on Thursday, so I've just been to Snowy's. I'm all set up in my massive car, everything's set up. I think I may have hired a car that is too large. It is the size of a bus. I could quite easily sleep in the back of it. So I'm going to start heading up now to Port Augusta. Hopefully I'm going to stop off at a supermarket of some sort on the way and get some stuff that will help me not die in the desert, which will be fine, of course it will. Not expecting to see much cool stuff today. The journey up to Port Augusta doesn't look very interesting, but you know, it's an experience and I've never been this route, which is new for me and Australia. So yeah, let's get on, let's get some adventuring going.
I'm at the queen of whatever, drink with the Irish, smoke with the hippies, move with the shakers.
Try that again. It's Friday morning, 7:20 a.m. I am in Port Augusta. Stayed in a hotel last night because the weather was shit, and I'm really pleased that I did because it was windy and horribly rainy overnight. So I'm just going to fill up, and today is where the cool stuff starts. So I'm going to head towards Cooper Pedy, I think they call it, and there's all kinds of cool stuff on the way. It's probably a good 5-6 hours drive, so it's going to be quite tiring, but I'm hoping I'm going to see some cool shit on the way.
But I'm taking the long way, taking the long way around, taking the long way, taking the long way around.
Okay, there is a small kind of desert camouflage spider 8-legged thing crawling over my dashboard, and it keeps disappearing into the dashboard, and it's making me slightly terrified. If I was in the city, I think I'd probably pull over and set fire to the whole thing, but I kind of need the vehicle, so I think what I might do is stop somewhere and fill it with Dettol or bleach or something. Yeah, and it jumps about.
Well, I've never seen her do it like anybody else.
for me to go. The autumn moonlight's my way. But now I smell the rain, and with it pain, and it's heading my way. Sometimes I grow so tired.
I'm having to check my diary to see what day it is because I'm losing track. 7:35, just got up, camped out underground at that Reba's place in Cooper Beatty. Kind of cool. One thing I didn't think through, other people basically chatting or snoring or moving or farting. You hear it a lot because of course it echoes around the whole place. So yeah, perhaps not on the way back. The stars last night were amazing, but I was just too knackered to take any advantage of it. But I do have the trip back to do that, so that's what I'm planning. So, overground camping from now on. Realise it's colder in the desert than I expected, so hopefully I'm going to see a camp shop probably nearer Uluru than between here and Uluru, because I don't think there is anything. And then hopefully get a warmer sleeping bag. But yeah, quite a long trek today. Probably 500-600 kilometers, I think, if not further, 7 or 8 hours of driving. But yeah, hopefully today I should get my first glimpse of Uluru, which I'm kind of excited about.
Finally made it to Uluru. hell of a lot further than I thought, but very satisfying getting here. And I have to say, it's just stunning. It's actually quite overpowering, I don't know, one of those. Currently doing the base walk, which is about 10k, I think, I hope. Probably maybe a 3-hour walk, possibly. Great photo ops on the way, though. Really wasn't prepared for. It's not just how the place looks. I mean, it's a hell of a lot bigger than I thought, but I wasn't surprised at what it looked like, because everyone knows what Uluru looks like. I think for me, what's been really surprising is how the place feels. It sounds really odd. I'm about as spiritual as a hedgehog, but there is something here. Can't put it to words. It's just a feeling of age, I guess. Is it spiritual? I don't know. I that's way above my pay grade, I suspect. But what I do know is it's you don't just see it. You kind of feel it. I can't help wondering whether I feel the same way if I hadn't made the effort to travel here properly. I guess it's so easy just to jump on a plane, you know, Adelaide, spend 4 hours get off, get a bus, have a look around, you know, be American, basically. I am dressed like an American tourist. Would it feel the same? I don't think it'd be the same experience. Travelling's kind of the point, isn't it? One thing that is really cool is once you get away from the main tourist 2K walk, it's pretty desolate. There's hardly any people here. I can't imagine what it'd be like midsummer. I'm kind of pleased I did avoid it. 40 odd degrees, I just can't even function. But anyway, I can't see a person at all. And it's brilliant. The other thing I meant to talk about was the journey up here. It was an effort. The distance was just overwhelming. It's really hard to imagine, because if you do that kind of distance in the UK, where would you end up, apart from ending up in the sea? Where would you end up? Eastern Russia, I guess? Okay, it's day 4 in Mac years. Getting a bit weary now. Nearly back at the car now, so I guess that's about 70, maybe 80 miles I've walked. Okay, 10 kilometres or 11. It's worth it though. It's so goddamn pretty. Olga's next. I've just caught sight of my car. You have no idea how happy I am about this. Worth it, though.
Thank you. So it's Sunday the 28th. It's about 5 to 8 in the morning. I'm just starting the last stretch into Sydney, so I've probably got about 350k to go, maybe 330. So doing pretty well schedule wise. I can end up exactly a day behind schedule, which isn't too bad, I don't think, in the scheme of things. I was supposed to drop the car back this morning, but I've extended it till tomorrow morning. Really pleased I stayed in a motel last night, even if it was a bloody freezing motel, because I came out and the car's covered in ice. So I'm guessing staying in the car would have been hideous. So into Sydney, get there around midday. Not quite sure what I'm going to do first. I'm probably going to head down to Bondi, I guess, and go find somewhere decent for lunch, I reckon. Then get checked into the hotel and then go drop this stuff off to Mikey. But yeah, quite looking forward to seeing Sydney. I always feel happy when I end up in that place. Such a beautiful, beautiful city. But yeah, onwards and upwards.